Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Greg Hager Night of New Beginnings Christmas Show. Let's give a big welcome to Greg Hager.
Thank you. It is a privilege to be here. It's a privilege to get to be in my hometown for one weekend of the year. We've been a pretty busy year for us. As Steve said, we'll introduce a band in a moment. We're going to sing the story of Christmas, probably in a way that you haven't heard it before. All the music that I share from the platform, these are all original songs, ways that I would like the story to be told unto me. We're going to start it off with the story about the shepherds. A shepherd is usually watching his sheep. He sings and he counts at night, he doesn't sleep. The lonely were who the Lord chose to draw nigh. Glory, glory, they heard from on high. Glory, glory, they heard from on high. Silent night, oh holy night, the baby in the manger has made it all right. Peace on earth and goodwill toward men. Tell me the story again. The cattle were lowing just like they do now. They were spreading the good news the best they knew how. Under the stars is the best place to sing. The shepherds first met the new king. Oh, the shepherds first met the new king. Silent night, oh holy night, the babe in the manger has made it all right. Peace on earth and goodwill toward men, tell me the story again. A staff is a comfort that's held in the hand, leading the sheep safe across pasture's land. God chose the tender in spirit and heart, the first ones to salvation impart. The first ones to salvation impart. Silent night, oh holy night, the babe in the manger has made it all right. Peace on earth and goodwill toward men, tell me the story again. Silent night, oh holy night, the babe in the manger has made it all right. Peace on earth and goodwill toward men, tell me the story again. A shepherd is usually watching his sheep. He sings and he counts at night, he doesn't sleep. Thank you. I'm going to have Hannah join us for the stage. We'll be introducing my family and the band here shortly, but Hannah and I sat down, and this is a song that Hannah wrote, and maybe she's taken in her dear old dad's footprints just a little bit, but this is our daughter, Hannah Hager. She's 18 years old now, a freshman at Trinity Bible College in Ellendale, and you want to tell them the name of your song?
It's called Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hannah Hager.
Thank you.
Makes the dad pretty proud, it does. Well, what, in the first part of our story here, I want to sort of be like a movie, and I want to give you a picture of the characters of the Christmas story, and then tell the story as it goes. Andrea is going to join us next, and this next part of the story has to do with Mary. We've touched on the shepherds. We touched very briefly on the wise men, and we'll come back to those wise guys in a little bit. My wife, Andrea, joining the stage here.
Is there anybody out there? I can't see anything up here. Sorry, I just had to say that.
But you see, the angel came. The Bible says that the angel came to Mary and told her that she was highly favored and that she had been chosen to be the mother of the Savior of all mankind. And you see, Mary could have been like us and been a little bit like, oh, no, that's too big of a responsibility for me, and said, I can't do it, God, I can't do it. But Mary didn't. She made a declaration which I think is one of the most powerful in the Bible itself. She simply said, let it be unto me exactly as it was spoken.
How can it be that I am favored? Why would the Most High honor me? The angel of the Lord said it would happen that the Son of God would live inside of me. Be it unto me as it was spoken, a servant of the Lord I choose to be. Mercy will extend through generations. Here I am, Lord, be it unto me. Here I am, Lord, be it unto me.
We'll get them back later, okay? I want to take a second and introduce the guys up here. They're I'm proud to say they're all friends of mine. I'll start to my left. Over here, Carrie Wicks from Jamestown, North Dakota, on just about everything. In the back corner, Stephen Thomas from here in Valley City. Next to him, his dad, Donnie Taran from Tower City. Steve Kuykendall, friend of mine from Jamestown, North Dakota. On the far right is Nick Holden from Page, North Dakota on the steel and dobro guitar. And lastly, every basket of thorns needs to have a rose. So we've got Aaron Harris from right here in Valley City. Tradition tells us that when the shepherds were out in the fields tending watch over their flock by night, that the sky shone bright when the angels came and announced that just down the hill, just down a little ways, they could go and they could see the new Messiah and be the first to go give him acknowledgement that the Messiah had come. And I made a play on that as a writer. I took, that idea of being in midnight clear. Was it or wasn't it? I don't care. It's a good tradition. I kind of like to retell it that way. But this is a perspective of what happened on that midnight clear. An angel said, "Shepherds, don't fear. This night is born very near in David's town, not far away. A babe in a manger will lay. These things will a sign for you be. If you seek, you'll find, and then see a swaddle tiding of great joy, the blessed baby boy." Then suddenly in midnight clear, with angels singing everywhere, glory to God, oh most high, on earth goodwill toward men. Oh, on earth, goodwill toward men. The shepherd said, "Let's up and go, so our eyes can see what we know." They came with haste and found it true. Then they did what good shepherds do. They went right back up to their fields. Messiah had now been revealed. Abroad the shepherds spread the word of what they'd seen and heard. How suddenly in midnight clear, with angels singing everywhere, glory to God, oh most high, on earth goodwill towards men, oh on earth goodwill toward men. God, oh most high, on earth goodwill toward men, oh on earth goodwill toward men. Thank you. And they had reason to be joyful, didn't they? It was a birthday. You see, the entire Old Testament talked about the fact that Messiah would come. And then finally, on that night, in midnight clear, Messiah did come. It was a birthday, not a birthday that was celebrated for the next year because it was the first one. And we'll talk more about the first later, but Hannah's going to talk about this birthday party. It was the birthday of the King.
In the little village of Bethlehem, there lay a child one day, and the sky was bright with a holy light o'er the place where Jesus lay. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you.
Thank you, Hannah. It was a birthday, and what do you do at a birthday party, right? You have guests come over. Well, there was a group of guests who came to the birthday who, as tradition would have us in the desert, what do you do in the desert? You either go on foot or you maybe take a little trek on a camelback. And this is one of the new songs that we're playing for the first time publicly tonight. And if you see me referencing this little stage over here, it's, you know, I'm not quite old enough that I forget everything yet, but this paints a picture of the wise men. We talked earlier that we were going to explore the wise men just a little bit further. So instead of taking a bunny trail, we're going to take a little trip down some camel tracks.
Wise men loaded camels and they traveled from afar. Through sand and sun they journeyed towards an eastern star. They asked Herod where to go to find the King of Jews. But Herod's heart was troubled at the revelating news. Judea's Bethlehem is where the prophet said, "My people Israel will be by shepherd ruler led." "Search the countryside," said Herod, "then come back to me. I want to go and worship and the Jewish king to see." Ooh. wise men found the child, and they worshipped him that day. Brought gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh, but could not stay. God had sent a dream to go a different way back home. So back across the desert with their camels they did roam. When Herod learned the wise men had gone home a different way, he had boy children slaughtered, age of 2 and less that day. Magi had outwitted him, and Herod fumed so mad. God's revealing dream had saved the good guys from the bad. God preserved the boy king down in Egypt for a while, fulfilling prophecy of old and doing it in style. How long they stayed in Egypt, the scripture doesn't say. When news had spread of Herod's death, they went back home to stay. If you're wondering what's the lesson in this story now for me, it's that God will make a way when human eyes just cannot see. He has a plan, don't worry, 'cause your story isn't true through. If you forget, then just remember, it's there. I said it's there. My friends, it's there in Matthew chapter 2.
Thank you. See, so you can say, I actually heard some new Christmas music this year. Not the same three songs that they've been playing since before Thanksgiving on the radio, right? Well, most of you know my roots are here in Valley City. My folks live on the Hager homestead established in 1883, and I grew up just a mile south of Green School, to sort of put my life in perspective. We live now just a mile south and a mile west of the old school, southwest of town. And growing up on the land and growing up with critters, you appreciate a lifestyle, kind of the Western lifestyle, the whole story of the American cowboy, as it were. I always like to romanticize about the old West and say, you know, the days then were better, you know, that they could spend all day riding and maybe not having all these stresses that we seem to work with. But so what I did is I tried to paint a picture, is history tells us that nothing has changed and that we still want to get home for Christmas. And the American cowboy was no different. He wanted to get back to a place off the trail that he belonged in. And he was especially lucky if he went home to somebody. Here's Christmas and Cowboys.
Christmas and cowboys and great northern lights. It's warm by the fire on December nights. 2 months of riding, he soon will be home. Omaha beckons wherever he roams. And off in the distance, the hazy skies glow. He'll make it by nightfall, and it's starting to snow. He's got someone waiting back there by lamplight. The soup is still stewing, the stoked fire bright. And joy to the world's on his mind. And peace for all men is what he's hoping to find. The season is merry, the reason is right. It's not about Santa, but Jesus tonight. It's not about Santa, but Jesus tonight. He's got whorehound candy and lemon drops too, a shawl for his wife and a dress made of blue. 2 months of driving them old doggies home. He hopes he can stay now and not have to roam. And joy to the world's on his mind. And peace for all men is what he's hoping to find. The season is merry, the reason is right. It's not about Santa, but Jesus tonight. It's not about Santa, but Jesus tonight. He stables his horse in the barn, pitches hay down into the manger, and he starts to pray. His mind sees a baby with a small wrinkled nose, cuddled with Mary in wrapped swaddling clothes. And joy to the world's on his mind. And peace for all men is what he's hoping to find. The season is merry, the reason is right. It's not about Santa, but Jesus tonight. It's not about Santa, but Jesus tonight.
Thank you. Well, I asked my Grandpa Hager, my dad's dad, not too long before he passed away, and you know, when you have good memories of someone, it's always hard to sort of quell back emotions regardless where you are. But I said to Grandpa one time, I said, "Grandpa, tell me about the good old days." And he looked at me as only someone who's earned all the gray hairs on his head can do. He said, "Greg, the good old days weren't that good. It was mostly hard work." I thought, "You got a point there, Grandpa." And we had another nice conversation, and that's always stuck with me, because you know, we tend to look backwards, and they say that hindsight is 20/20. And we tend to look back and say, "Oh, that was the good times back then. If we could just go back and have good times." When the truth is that kind of how we look at life now determines whether these are going to be the good times as we go forward, that every day can be a good time. And I look at the traditions that my grandpa passed down, the traditions that my folks passed down, and then the traditions that I'm hoping to pass on to my kids. And somewhere my son William is, I can't really see where he is, but if he runs across the stage here, you'll know him. He'll probably do one of these quick things. And I've got a daughter, Holly, who I can just barely make out over there. Holly, can you wave your hand real quick? That's Holly. She's 14. And we're blessed as a family, but I like to say that, you know, I've part of a long line of dreamers, and I hope that continues on. I once asked a man about the years of yester. Wisdom answered with a twinkle in his eye. The
Good old days were not everything you think of. Took lots of hardship to get by. But I come from a long line of dreamers who saw the glass of life half full, who got it done by being workers and not schemers, and whose eyes were never covered up by wool. It's been said I dream about the years of yester, but in my heart I know the best is yet to come. Looking back can help give you perspective, 'cause who I am's where I come from. And I come from a long line of dreamers who saw the glass of life half full, who got it done by being workers and not schemers, and whose eyes were never covered up by wool. Years from now, these days will be the years of yester, and if I'm asked, I'll tell it true. Now's the moment to be planning on your future. Your legacy is up to you, because you come from a long line of dreamers who saw the glass of life half full, who got it done by being workers and not schemers, and whose eyes were never covered up by wool. Yes, you come from a long line of dreamers who saw the glass of life half full, who got it done by being workers and not schemers, and whose eyes were never covered up by wool.
So keep that in mind, because we wouldn't be here if somebody ahead of us didn't have a dream to get something accomplished. Well, we opened up the can of worms about some of the traditions of Christmas earlier. And we can't say Christmas without people thinking about Saint Nick, right? Santa Claus. So I thought we should tell a story about Santa Claus. And do I still have a couple of kids going to help me, Aaron? Katie, are you here? You can't tell a story if you don't have someone to tell it to, can you? There she comes. She's ready. This is Katie Harris. This is Aaron's daughter. Let me have you stand right over here. Here, I bet you could sit on this box. You try sit right here. There you go. Well, I'm going to tell you the story about Santa Claus, okay? His name's Santa Claus. He lives in the hills. You've probably never seen the one that brings Christmas thrills. He's got a little workshop where elves make all the toys. Scoot up a little closer and listen, girls and boys. His nose and his clothes are red, what a sight. His hair and his beard are both snowy white. He's got a tasseled cap to keep out the chills. And he's never been late, and he never will. With the ho, 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 Saint Nick climbs into his sleigh. With the ho, 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 the flying deer take him away.
when he's done at the end of the flight. Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night. Christmas time is here. Let's all spread good cheer. Santa'll ho-ho-ho right back next year. Santa has two lists, one naughty, one nice. And if you want some presents, you'll take my advice. Never stop believing in your heart. Share and don't fight, that'll be a good start. He likes milk and cookies and socks hung with care. And if you'll do these things, you can bet he'll be there. You can set your plate by the Christmas tree. And all this is true, so I hope you're listening to me. With the ho, 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 Saint Nickel climbs into his sleigh. With the ho, 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 the flying deer take him away. And when he is done at the end of the flight, Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night. Christmas time is here. Let's all spread good cheer. Santa'll ho, ho, ho right back next year. Santa'll ho, ho, ho right back next year.
Thank you, Katie. Thank you. Good job.
Katie Harris, folks. You can just get talent like that all the time. If my kids looked at me that attentively when I had something to tell them, too. Speaking of my kids, when they were younger, all three of my kids had blonde hair and blue eyes. And when they were younger, I'd say something to them, and this has nothing to do with the songs, guys. I'd say to them, go be who you are today. And as only kids can do, they look up at you with those eyes and say, like, what, Dad? You know, you've seen it. Like, so that explain, you know, that means you're a good kid, you're a good student, you know what the rules are. You follow the rules because that's who you are. And so you should be who you are. Well, as the kids got older, I would say things like, stop fighting, go be who you are. But my kids didn't have blue eyes anymore. They became white as they rolled into the recesses of their brain. So I've been there, parents, grandparents. We're going to do one more song and then take about a 15-minute break so you have a chance to go get some refreshments and use facilities if you need to. I do have a couple of helpers out there to direct you. Basically, though, underneath the bleachers, the men's on this side, the ladies on this side if you need to use the facilities. And, of course, I think we overbaked Christmas goodies, so have like a dozen each. But last song in this set, and then we're going to take that short break. Actually, before I do that, each of you, I'll mention again later, you are each given a program tonight. And I want to ask something personal for you guys is putting on a production like this is a challenge and a costly adventure. And inside of that brochure are listed some sponsors who came on board and partnered with me, who said, Greg, we believe in your show and we want to help cover some of those expenses. folks, we have a choice when it comes to where we do our business. And if you've appreciated what we're doing here on the stage, please look through there. And the next time you have a good or service that's needed, take a look at those sponsors and say, I want to do business with these folks. A couple that I do want to make special mention of is Frontier Ag, and then also Valley Plains Equipment stepped up and really helped in a really big way. And of course, we have a lot of great other sponsors in there too. So please look at it. Everybody was important, and it made this show take place. If you need a Christmas tree, Smith Lumber in Valley City here now has trees in stock and a good selection of them, so keep that in mind. And lastly, I've got a sponsor from Kansas City who sent up some barbecue products. And each of you were given a little thank you, a ticket. I can't see you, but I hear your voice. Oh, it's my wife. I thought it was an angel.
Good save.
Each of those tickets, look at it. We've got, they should about be done. I've got about 25 different barbecue products from through the Smoke Barbecue Company that are sent up. And if your number matches one of the ones on the table, take it home, give it a sample, and at minimum, please say thank you to the folks who've helped make the show possible. We're going to sing an upbeat song about that red-nosed guy, Rudolph. Take it away, guys.
One year Santa sipped his nog, and there blew in a dreadful fog. He couldn't see to guide the sleigh, but he had to load up anyway. Rudolph. Rudolph. He couldn't let the children down. He had to get to every town. He thought and thought and thought it through. And then he knew just what to do. Get Rudolph. Rudolph. Your nose is red like mine. Everything will be just fine. They won't make fun this time, Rudolph. There's lots of girls and boys that need their Christmas toys. So let's all make some noise for Rudolph. So Santa headed to the barn to get the deer. This ain't no yarn. He heard 'em grumble through the straw about the thing that they just saw with Rudolph. Rudolph. They stepped into the harness line. As Santa said, we'll be just fine. We're gonna make it through tonight with you know who's bright shiny light. Rudolph. Rudolph. This ain't no reindeer game. We'll never be the same. Give thanks and never more blame Rudolph. There's lots of girls and boys that need their Christmas toys. So let's all make some noise for Rudolph. Take it away, Aaron. A little bit of saxophone. A little bit of steel. And
lead guitar.
This ain't no reindeer game. We'll never be the same. Give thanks and never more blame Rudolph. There's lots of girls and boys that need their Christmas toys. So let's all make some noise for Rudolph. There's lots of Christmas toys that need those girls and boys. So let's all make some noise for Rudolph.
To sneak Hannah back up to the stage, guys. It's a family show, and so I promised we'd have Hannah back up, and you guys can... Well, see, Hannah can do something that none of the rest of us can do. So if someone can do something that you can't do, it's always good to say, hey, why don't you take care of that, right?
I went out to Medora, where all the cowboys be, to try to learn to yodel with my E-diddle-o-dee-o. I climbed a big high mountain on a clear and sunny day. There I met a cowboy who was yodeling away. He taught me to yodel, yodel. To go faster. We're going way too slow.
Okay, can you keep up?
Yeah. Now I'm gonna teach you all to yodel just like me. It's easier when you're singing to go woodley. First you take a deep breath and exhale one, two, three. Then you'll hear the yodeling sound if you listen close to me. This is how to yodel, yodel, ay-dee-dee-ay, oon-diddle, ay-dee-dee-ay, oon-diddle, ay-dee. This is how to yodel, yodel, ay-dee-dee-ay, oon-diddle, oon-diddle, ay-dee. And diddle, ay-dee-dee-ay, oon-diddle, oon-diddle, ay-dee-dee-ay, oon-diddle, oon-diddle, ay-dee-dee-ay, oon-diddle, oon-diddle, ay-dee-dee-ay.
And then you go.
Okay. Want to yodel one more time? Hannah Hager.
Thank you.
Oh, how I wish I could yodel. Well, the first half of our show, a little bit over that time, we painted the picture of some of the traditions and some of the things that make up this Christmas season so great. A little bit about Mary, and the story of the birth of Jesus, about the camels and about the wise men, about the shepherds who kept watch over their flocks by night, and painting the picture of all those things, the angels that came, what they did, what they sang. And then we talked about Santa, and we talked about Rudolph. And you know, it all goes back to something. Even the lowly Christmas tree, the traditions of having lights on the tree, are thanks to Martin Luther. He wanted to capture what he'd seen out in the woods when the sun and the moonlight, or the moonlight and the stars, was twinkling on the branches. And so he was the first to light the Christmas tree when he brought it into his house. These traditions are all great, but every culture in the world recognizes it with some form or fashion that Jesus actually came. They celebrate Christmas in every country around this world of ours. And we could look at all these great traditions and we could say, you know, oh, it's Christmas is all about Santa, but no, it's really about the fact that we're celebrating a birthday, the birthday of Jesus Christ.
Seems that when I look around, I see so much commerciality. It's Santa this and happy that, and silver bells and Frosty's hat. There are people bustling everywhere. I wonder if they really care. I think the season's very nice, but some people don't think twice. That if it weren't for Jesus, there would not be Christmas. There'd be nothing special about that day. The world would still be searching for a Savior, and none of this would matter anyway. If the Father had not loved enough to save us, if it weren't for Jesus, there would not be Christmas. Every year I get a Christmas tree and adorn it with nativity. Up at the top I place a star that led the wise men from afar. Below the angels who sang where the baby would be lying there, in manger and with swaddled clothes. That's the way the story goes. But if it weren't for Jesus, there would not be Christmas. There'd be nothing special about that day. The world would still be searching for a Savior, and none of this would matter anyway. If the Father had not loved enough to save us, if it weren't for Jesus, there would not be Christmas. Oh, Jesus is the reason we have Christmas.
See, the Bible says that every knee shall bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. The idols that we make in life still yield to the lordship of Jesus Christ. Thank you, guys. We We talked at the first half that there was a first Christmas when there wasn't tradition, there wasn't anything, no expectation of what might be or should be or could be, but simply realizing that the Jesus had been born, that the Messiah had come. And you see, Mary couldn't celebrate a birthday because it was the birthday, not a celebration of it. The wise men didn't know what to do, so they came, and the Bible says that they came and saw the Christ child and then went back to what they did. They realized that they were changed in their heart, but then they went back to what their job was. And I love that story because what should have been worldwide, in one sense, the happiest occasion in the world, was sort of a sad story because Jesus didn't come the way that the people expected that they would, that they thought he would come as the King of Kings and the ruler of all Israel coming in and being on a horse and some kind of pomp or circumstance to make clear that, hey, I am the King, I am the Messiah, but he came as a baby and changed the world from the manger.
Augustus the Caesar had issued the world a decree. So Joseph and Mary, they traveled from old Galilee. Foretold by the ancients, a lamb would face scorn. In the city of David be born. A maystable would witness the birth of a king. For the first time men heard angels sing. And all things were pondered, what else could she do? It was her first Christmas too. Was Mary's first Christmas too. And there was rejoicing, the Savior had come. Glory to God was their cry. And wise men still seek him and make him their own. Forever his name lifted high. There on the hillside, the shepherds were told what to do. Go into the city and fear not, here's a sign unto you. You'll find mankind's Savior in swaddling clothes. The lowly were who the Lord chose. The baby was there in a manger of hay, amazed by what they'd seen that day. They spread the word, what else could they do? It was their first Christmas too, the shepherd's first Christmas too. And there was rejoicing, the Savior had come. Glory to God was their cry. And wise men still seek him and make him their own. Forever his name lifted high. I'll always remember the story, and I know it's true. It's there in the Bible, recorded in Luke chapter 2.
Thank you. I love looking at photographs. I love Christmas time, and in years past, you'd sit and pull out the albums because you could flip through and you could have someone tell you who so-and-so was, and that was your great-uncle so-and-so, and that was cousin Billy Bob, 5th removed, 2nd, whatever it was. And you look back, but it was a picture that captured a moment. And the same as now is we've got our smartphones, and we capture. You know, we have so much capture that we maybe aren't realizing that each picture has an opportunity to retell a story. So before you this night, I'm going to lay 4 photographs right in front of you. And I want you to take a journey with me as we step into the years of yester. I often think about the years of yester, how it was so different way back when. Times were hard, yet it seems most folks were happy. If we could just get back there again. Shaking hands in the years yester, a man's word could be relied upon. Women folk were honored and respected, and now it seems that chivalry is gone. Work was hard in the years of yester. Folks could quit when they would get it done. Times are hard, yet it seems most folks were thankful. Sears and Roebuck, it wasn't always fun. Christmas time in the years of yester. Treasured gifts, sometimes only one. A paper bag with nuts and ribbon candy. Grateful hearts that the Father sent His Son. To take time and reflect, to paint a picture of what is, what could be, maybe what should be again. And there's a couple things that I've decided in these last couple years in particular that it seems like, you know, you get too wrapped up in the commercial side of the giving, and it's a great tradition, I'm not knocking that, to give a gift of value and say, hey, I love you, and here's one more reminder of it. But to look at Christmas and say, you know, what does it really matter? What's the point? What's the meaning? And I tell you what I want more than anything is what this next story talks about. It's a song that I call This Christmas. What do I want this Christmas? What do I want to see? 'Cause I've seen lights, mistletoe and all the sights. They don't mean that much to me. What do I want this Christmas?
What could change it all for me? 'Cause I've run around to buy the gifts and pay the down. But that's not happiness for me. I guess I'd like a simple Christmas with my friends and family. Thinking about the blessed occasion when God sent His Son for me. If I could have a simple Christmas, it would mean the world to me. What could I give this Christmas? What would mean the most from me? Would little things like a package tied with strings lay beneath the Christmas tree? What could I give this Christmas? What could be my legacy? Tradition's fine, and I celebrate with mine. But it's not everything for me. I guess I'd give a simple Christmas with my friends and family. Thinking about the blessed occasion when God sent His Son for me. If I could give a simple Christmas, oh, how happy I would be. If I could have a simple Christmas, it would mean the world to me.
Andrea is going to join me again, and that really is kind of the paradigm. I've hit 44 years of age in life, and you learn a few things when you're willing to learn, and one of those is realizing that what matters really, it's not the gift. I mean, that's a nice token, and as I mentioned earlier, it's a nice, I love you, here's something special for you, but to say it's about family, it's about friends, it's about remembering the object at the birthday party. So, Andrea joining me here on the last couple of songs that we have for you tonight. It has been a privilege to be here. And this song talks about coming home.
How many times have you ever woken to frost on a window pane? Counted the hours till school would be over so you could play again. That's how it was when I was a kid all those years ago. I couldn't wait to open my presents for Grandma's house to go. Coming home for Christmas. Coming home to see everything that matters is free. Coming home for Christmas. Making spirits bright. Coming home for Christmas tonight. How many times have you ever waited for someone to arrive? Or anxiously prayed through a terrible blizzard in which you chose to drive? I now believe it's not the presents underneath the tree that adds to the meaning of this special time. It is family. Coming home for Christmas. Coming home to see everything that matters is free. Coming home for Christmas, making spirits bright. Coming home for Christmas tonight. Everything that matters is completely free. Happy birthday, Jesus. Thanks for coming home for me.
Thank you. Our last song for the night is trying to summarize this whole Christmas experience that I do want to mention from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for coming out to the show tonight. It means a lot to me. It really does. My request earlier, please look through your program and take a look at the folks who've helped to cover some of the expenses with the band and with the facility rental and lights and sound and all those types of things. And please look through, and if you're a note writer, write a little note, let them know that you really appreciated them taking time to support and their financial dollars to support what we're doing here. Secondly, I put phone numbers in there. It means you can call them and say thank you, and that's all good. But lastly, I would make a personal request. Stop in and let your dollars be your voice as well. Tell them thank you with your business. And I always like to say, do business with the people that support the things that you support. And that way, we'll keep those type of events going on longer. We'll be around after the show. I've got my music available for sale. A good friend of mine, Dan Cochran, and his leather company, he makes all the leather that I wear. And so there's a lot of great lifetime gift ideas to take home. Incidentally, lots of those will fit right into a stocking. But I want to wrap up this Christmas story this way. We've sung about Santa and Rudolph and the angels and Mary and the wise men and the camels and all the things that we kind of associate with Christmas. But the really crux of the question, the question I want to leave you with tonight is, what are you going to do with the Christ of Christmas now that you've heard the full story? That really is the question of our life, is what will you do with the Christ child? What will you do with the one who came on our behalf and paid the price of the cross to rise again, that we could accept him and have forgiveness and actually live? And that's a question I want to leave you with tonight, through the perspective of a night like this, but through a night of new beginnings. Was a night of new beginnings, a way to start again. That night when Jesus came into my life, there upon the hillside, I watched the angels sing, announce with joy the birth of my new King. So I went into the village, found the sheep out on the hill. I went to see the thing the angels say. That was when I found him, and when he looked at me, my life was changed when I knelt there on my knee. I found the King of Glory, and I found the King of Kings. My life's complete, I found the better way. Messiah came down to me and fulfilled the prophecy. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, I am free. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, I am free. I was once a wise man, with comrades we were three. We saw the star and started on our way. We thought he'd come in splendor, enthroned in majesty. I was changed when I knelt there on my knee. I found the King of Glory, and I found the King of Kings. My life's complete, I found the better way. Messiah came down to me and fulfilled the prophecy. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, I am free. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, I am free. Was a night of new beginnings, a way to start again. That night when Jesus came into my life, on my knees down by my bedside, it's where I knelt to pray. I was born again, my sins were washed away. I found the King of Glory, and I found the King of Kings. My life's complete, I found the better way. Messiah came down to me and fulfilled the prophecy.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, I am free. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, I am free.
Thank you, Andrea. Thanks to the band. Thank Nick Holden, Aaron Harris, Steve Kuykendall, Donnie Tarrin, Stephen Thomas, and Carrie Wicks. And on behalf of my family, we thank you so very much. Thank you for coming here.
And let's give it up for Greg Hager.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, I've got one for you.
Crackling fire, the howling wind, the lights are turned down low. I look upon the manger scene, and my heart begins to glow. Pausing to remember the story and the way. Amazed by all that happened back there on that day. Was a silent night, a holy night, 2,000 years ago. That love came down to shed a light so everyone could know. The greatest gift of Christmas is not one you give away. It's yours if you'll receive it. There's no price you have to pay. And it's a gift that keeps on giving. It's a gift that's here to stay. It's not wrapped in strings and ribbons, but swaddled in clothes upon the hay. And I hope that you'll receive it, for there's nothing you can do. It's just asking you to forgive. Gift of Christmas is for you. Was a silent night, a holy night, 2,000 years since then. That love came down to shed a light and change me from within. I received the gift of Christmas, and I will never be the same. The love I have, the life I live, Jesus gave my heart a flame. And it's a gift that keeps on giving. It's a gift that's here to stay. It's not wrapped in strings and ribbons, but swaddled in clothes upon the hay. And I hope that you receive it, 'cause there's nothing you can do. Just ask him to forgive. The gift of Christmas is for you. And it's a gift that keeps on giving. It's a gift that's here to stay. It's not wrapped in strings and ribbons, but swaddled in clothes upon the hay. And I hope that you'll receive it, 'cause there's nothing you can do. Just ask him to forgive. The gift of Christmas is for you. The gift of Christmas is for you. Thank you.
Let's sing a song together and then we'll wrap it up. Joy to the World, maybe we all know it. I'll try and call out the verses if my eyes and my 32-inch syndrome will let me do it here.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing.
Joy to the world.
Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ. While fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy. Repeat, repeat the sounding joy. No more let sin and sorrow grow, nor thorns infest the ground. He comes to make his blessings flow, far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found. And he rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love.
Thank you, folks. Have a Merry Christmas.